In this section, we'll be covering color swatches. Color swatches are very useful because it allows you to maintain consistency across your designs by easily just reusing specific colors. Okay, let's go and select the swatches panel. It's right next to the color panel, so select it, and if you don't see it there, you can go ahead and go to Window, scroll down, and you'll see swatches there. Select that, and it will pop up in your studio somewhere. So now that it's open, we want to create our own swatch palette. So we'll head on over to the burger menu and we'll click on that. We have a bunch of options here, but what we want to do here is create an application palette. And basically that means that this swatch palette will be available across Affinity Designer. Doesn't matter which document you're using. Of course you have some different options here, but we'll just concentrate on that. So I'm gonna go ahead and click on it. And now we have to name it. I'll call it Swatch Tutorial and I'll press okay. And now you can see we have our own swatch category, swatch tutorial. So let's go ahead and add our first color. So I've created these squares here and I've chosen the color from the color tab. And these are the colors that I want to work with in my next design. So with the first one selected, I'm going to head on over to the swatches panel. And there's this little icon here. It says add current fill to palette. If I select that, you can see we now have that color there. So if I head on over to one of these gray squares down here, I've got that selected. I can apply this color by simply going up to my swatches panel and selecting the color I want. And of course you could do this with all of these, including gradients. So for this one, I made a gradient and I want to add it as a swatch. So same again, I can go ahead and click on this button. But also I want to note that you can just right click and scroll down to the bottom. And you see here we have add to swatches. So I can go ahead and click this one here from fill. If my shape had a stroke on it, an outline, I could sample that color of the outline there. Or I could sample both and it would add the outline color and the fill color of the shape. But for now, I'll just click on from fill. And you can see here we have two colors. One of them is a gradient and one of them is not. And right now I can't really tell when I hover over them. So I can right click and I can go ahead and rename the fill here, or I can delete it, make a copy, or I can edit it. So let's go ahead and add this gradient to this other gray square. I've selected it and now I'll go up to my gradient and click it. And we have a gradient applied. Okay, that's the basics of the swatches panel. But for now, I just want to delete one of them because I want to show you an extra feature. So I'll right click on this one and I will delete it. And now we're only left with that green color. So with the green color over here, I can right click on it. And you see down here, we have some more options, create color cord. Now I'm not going to go through all of them, but what I will click on is shades. So if I select this one, it will automatically give me shades of this color, making it really quick for me to just get the same color all in different shades. So I could save this as a swatch palette and just call it something else, maybe green shades. And if you're very happy with the swatches palette that you created and you want to make sure you save it in case maybe you have to delete Affinity Designer and reinstall it, you can go ahead and click on the burger menu again and then scroll down to export palette. And that's the basics of swatches.